Hello everyone, and welcome to my Linux gaming guide. In this video, I will cover everything you need to start gaming on Linux today. Before I begin, I want to say that I'm assuming that you already have a working Linux installation with the appropriate graphics card drivers installed, and that you know how to use your distro's package manager to install and uninstall software. Now that we have that out of the way, let's get to it. The first thing we're going to need to play games on Linux is, of course, Steam. Steam has a native Linux package, which you can install using your package manager. Once you got that sorted out, you can go to Steam and enable Steam Play. This uses a tool called Proton, developed by Valve, to run Windows games on Linux. To enable this, just go to Steam, Settings, Steam Play, tick both boxes and click OK. Steam will restart and Steam Play will be enabled. Now, there are different versions of Proton. You can choose which version a game is launched with by going to the properties of that game and selecting a specific version in the compatibility tab. I'm telling you this because while the latest version of Proton is the best in most cases, some games just work better with older or custom versions of Proton. Speaking of custom Proton versions, here is how you install them. I will give an example with Glorious Eggroll's custom Proton. Go to the releases page on GitHub and find the one you need. Download it. Move it to .steam root compatibility tools.d and extract it in that directory. Restart Steam, and you will be able to choose it in the Compatibility tab. As you may know, most games use some version of Microsoft's DirectX API. This is a problem because DirectX is proprietary and is not supported natively on Linux. So instead we use layers which translate DirectX to Vulkan. We have DXVK for DX9, 10 and 11 and VKD3D for DX12. While DXVK provides performance very close to that on Windows and even outperforms it in some cases, VKD3D has not yet caught up, and as it is now, you will take a massive performance hit with it. So, if the game you're trying to run supports DX11 and DX12, you should always use DX11. If a game has the option to use Vulkan, then use that, since Vulkan is supported natively on Linux and will most likely give you the best performance. In this section, I want to show you a few useful tools I use all the time. The first and most useful is Game Mode. This basically makes most games run better, so you definitely want to have this. You can install Game Mode by following the instructions on the GitHub page or just installing it using your package manager if your distro has it in its repositories. I'm using Arch Linux, so I just told Pacman to install Game Mode. You need to enable Game Mode on a per-game basis, so you need to go to the Steam launch options and type in Game Mode Run space percent command percent. That's pretty much all there is to it. MangoHood is a really nice monitoring and benchmarking tool. You can see it in action in the top left corner of the screen. It's pretty easy to build from source, and it also has packages available for some of the most popular distros, so you can install it with one simple command. To configure it to your liking, just copy the example config from user share MangoHood into .config MangoHood mangohood.conf and edit it to your liking. There is a list of what each variable does on the GitHub page, so enable and disable whatever you need. To enable MangoHood, type in MangoHood percent command percent in the Steam launch options. If you followed everything up until now, congratulations, you can now play about 85% of Windows games on Linux. In part 2, I will show you how to use Lutris to play non-Steam games on Linux, how to use Wine prefixes, how to use Wine tricks to install Windows DLL components, and how to apply the Windows Media Foundation fix required by some games. If you found this video helpful, leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss future content, and see you in the next one.